We are here today with Sydney, Divine on the Road, checking out her transit that she just had done. About why you chose van life. Like, what's so appealing to you about van life?
Van life? Okay, oh my God, that's a can of worms. Honestly, I've just always loved traveling, and all through college, I would save as much money as possible and then go take like a 2-week trip. Mm-hmm. And I think that just kind of got old. I wanted to be able to do it long term and full time, but flying everywhere is just really expensive. And so van life kind of was just the solution to all of the problems. Yeah. Like, you get to travel constantly. It's a way lower expense once you get the van done. And yeah, so I mean, you just get to change places kind of anytime you want. Yeah, we got your own pace.
We got Ella down here. Yeah,
she's a bit of a terror sometimes, but she's cute, so it's okay.
So you used to have another van. She had a Sprinter 144 yeah. prior to this van. So why did you go transit this time?
So the last time I was with my partner, and so we didn't really know much about the vans at all. We just saw so many Sprinters, so we went with that one, and we ended up having a lot of repair problems, and they were really, really expensive. You have to take them to Mercedes dealerships to get fixed, and so the prices were just crazy. And with the Transit, any mechanic can work on them. You don't have to take it to a dealership, and I was just a little bit more comfortable knowing I wouldn't have such a like hefty price after a repair, and anybody could take it. If I was in like a small town, I wouldn't have to tow it to a dealership and stuff, so it was just kind of me being a little bit more comfortable on my own, I guess.
We're excited to check out your transit. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
So,
thank you.
Can we get a tour?
Yeah, of course. Come on.
Let's go.
All right, so when you first walk in, this is our little control panel here for all the lights. So these are all lights. The last one would turn on the water. Sorry, van tour with a puppy. That's going to be interesting.
Oh, you don't have to apologize. Just let her do her thing.
And then,
because you're so freaking cute.
I can hold her if you want.
Okay, here. Okay, and then on this side is where I get ready. We have a little like glam mirror. I don't know. This was actually the builder. So I didn't build out the van myself. I designed it, but I didn't build it. And this was actually their idea. They just thought it would be kind of fun. And we wanted to go more of like a feminine vibe in this van than the last one. So yeah, that's my little getting ready mirror.
Super cool.
I just think it's fun. And then moving over here, this is my personal favorite little thing about the van. So because I am by myself, I wanted a way, if somebody at night is going to break into the front, just a way to separate the front from the back. So I have this little pocket door that just slides, and then a little pin that I can just slide in. So at least it buys me a couple minutes before they can make their way into the back, and I can kind of figure out a game plan. So I did like that being solo. And then we have a little drawer. Cutting board here. I'll show you the electrical. So that's all the electrical stuff. I have two 95 amp hour batteries, 400 watts of solar up top, and a 1500 watt inverter. That's all in there. The battery isolator's over there. And above all of that is my induction stove. So a lot of people go with propane. Propane's probably a lot easier, and that's why it's more common, but with the induction, it just pulls quite a bit of power. So, I mean, I've never had any issues with it, but I can only cook maybe once or twice a day, so if you plan on cooking a lot, I would probably go with the propane. But the induction is just nice because it kind of works like a regular stove. It only works if there's a pot on it, so I can't do that. But you just turn it on and then adjust to whatever heat temperature you want. And then moving along, we have my mason jars up here. I get a lot of questions about these. I promise they don't rattle when I drive. I was just telling them, I don't know why. Like, I don't know the science behind it. I just, everybody asks, and they don't rattle, they don't move. These are the kitchen drawers. We have three. This is like standard silverware, bowls, random like coffee pot stuff down in the bottom. Sink, running water. I don't have hot and cold water, so this is kind of like a trick, I guess. I don't know. And across from there is my Magic Chef fridge. I don't do the 12 volt fridges. They're just a little bit expensive, and we have somehow managed to make the 110 volt work. I know some people have issues with it. I don't know what the builders have done differently to make this one work, but I haven't had any problems with it so far. So it has a separate little freezer, fridges down there, and then this is angled like wine slots for wine bottles, but there's no wine in there right now. I have the dinette set up, so I have two benches on the sides, and then I'll show you it converts down to the table. And I have the lagoon table mount. They have another video on the lagoon table mount if you want to see like a full detailed version of that, but basically you just detach the table, it comes up, and it'll go down as the bed. And then above me are just my upper cabinets. This is just random stuff, toiletries. Up here, I have jewelry, chargers, girl stuff, I don't know. Here is where I keep, oh, keep that in, because that's what happens every single time, I swear. Okay, leggings, t-shirts, tank tops. I keep all of the clothes I wear almost every day, like up here, just so it's easier to get than getting in the benches. So that's kind of why I have all this set up here. This is all my camera stuff. I have a safe right here. And yeah, this entire thing is full of headbands. I never thought I'd have enough headbands for an entire bin, but you know, it happens. I have two benches on the side here, and then these cushions on this side, this one, and then those two. The two on the side come in the middle when I put the table down, and that basically just makes up a queen size bed, but it's a little bit bigger than a queen size. So I had to go to a separate fabric place and buy additional memory foam. So if you are going with a transit, I recommend buying a king bed and then cutting it down, because it was kind of a mess the way that I had to do it. This is my toilet. I'm still figuring out where I want it to go and what I want it to do. I only use it at night, so I really just kind of push it in the back and keep it wherever, but yeah, we're still kind of figuring out where I want that to go. So for now, it's just sitting there, not being cute, but it's fine. I have bookcases on either side, and then this is a slide-out table. And this is as big as the bed, so this is 72 inches as well, which it's just nice to like sit down and kind of work outside instead of being in the van a lot. I'm a homebody, even though I do van life, and so I get caught up in the van a lot, and so this is just kind of incentive to work outside a little bit more.
Yeah, I like that. That's really nice.
Yeah,
good idea.
Thank you. So we've added an eye bolt up here in between where the door locks, so I can hang my solar shower there and aerial silks for yoga and my little TRX. It's like a workout, those band things, and so I kind of hang all of those from here.
Oh,
and
smart.
It just, yeah, it was easy to add, and it kind of is really, really useful for all those things.
Since you're a solo female, what's some tips that you have? There's a lot of women out there that want to hit the road by themselves, so what are some like safety tips or just things to think about before you hit the road by yourself as a female?
Yeah, I would say as far as safety, I'm sorry, my dog is like chewing my shoes. As far as safety goes, I think you should really consider what would make you feel most safe. I think we all kind of have different things and like what we prefer. And so I have like a stun gun. I have pepper spray that I keep on her leash. So anytime I'm walking her early in the morning or at night, I know I have pepper spray on me. And I included the pocket door, and that was something I considered before we ever started building.
You also have this ferocious.
See, notice she knows not to do it to you guys. She's only gonna do it to me because she knows she can get away with it. But yeah, so before you even start building, think about something that you can incorporate in the layout or the build that you know will make you feel a little bit safer. Yeah. As far as just being a solo woman, I think it's really important to talk to as many people. This is gonna sound weird, but like talk to as many people throughout the day as you can. It's easy to feel lonely when you're by yourself. I mean, also get a dog because it's wonderful and you won't ever feel lonely. Yeah, you'll never feel lonely. But I've noticed being on the road by myself, like I'm so much more open to conversation during the day. Like even if it's at dog parks or on the street, like I talk to so many more people now than I did when I was doing van life with a partner, just because we had someone to talk to. And like, for some reason we just kind of ended up closing off a little bit. And so yeah, I would just suggest talking to as many people as you can. And I don't know, really investing in the places that you go, because it's really interesting and it's fun.
Yeah, you meet so many fun, cool people on the road.
Yeah.
I mean, we met through Instagram.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
How cool is that? Yeah. Sydney actually won one of our like Instagram.
Oh yeah, that's
giveaways.
How we met. That's how we met. Yeah, I still have that. I won a Braven speaker.
Yeah,
like how funny.
So cool. Thank you so much for letting us tour your van. There'll be links below for her Instagram and YouTube channel. You have a channel, but you don't have any videos on it.
Yeah, I'm working on it. I'm starting it.
So I'll link below to everything for Sydney and Ella. You can follow their adventures.
Yeah.
So thanks.
She's killing me right now.
Coming to visit us.
Yeah, of course.
All right. See you next time.
Bye, guys.
Bye.